I'm Gabby.
This week will be pretty cool and supposedly in the low 70s. In support of Breast Cancer Awareness Month, Blythewood held their Pink Out Rivalry Week.
The week was filled with a lot of fun activities and dress days like Beach Day, What Barbie Are You Day, and Dress Up as Ken Day.
There were also different activities to participate in and watch during lunch, like musical chairs, making pumpkins, taking photos in the Barbie-themed photo booth, and music in the atrium.
You could also walk on the track for $1, and all the proceeds were donated to the Famously Hot Pink Foundation.
HOSA also joined in by selling Starburst and Hershey Kisses for $1. To conclude the iconic week, there were a faculty versus student basketball game on Friday during fourth period, and the varsity football game against Rock Hill.
Thank you to all the students who participated in Rivalry Week. All the proceeds will be going to the Famously Hot Pink Association.
Now sports!
Football is coming up with three important events this week that you don't want to miss.
Starting on Thursday, B Team is having a home game against Spring Valley at 5:30.
On the same night, JV is also having a home game against the Vikings at 7:30.
And to finally end the week, Varsity will travel to Spring Valley at 7:30.
Good luck, Bengals. We know that you'll do well.
Speaking of an event that you don't want to miss, Pet and Cute Puppies.
That's right. On Monday, Thursdays, and Fridays, for $1, you'll be able to pet some cute puppies for 5 minutes. Watch this to learn more.
Small Animal Care is a class with hands-on experience with animals like cats, dogs, bunnies, chicks, etc. that follow after the agriculture science here at Blythewood High School. In this class, students participate in community leadership and development activities. This includes relevant classwork during school and work time during lunch. Their most current project is taking care of three puppies named Nyla, Bagel, and Spot, as well as their mother, Jackie. The assignment has left an impact on the entire class.
It's important because it somewhat helps with careers because it allows you that chance to truly learn the meaning of responsibility.
It's important for others because I feel like it shows like the responsibility of taking care of like any animal. So it like gives you a factor to weigh in when you want to get one.
Yes, it's really hands-on. It's good to know, like, it helps you prepare for like your future and stuff.
During this particular assignment, students also have to create an educational video informing people on the importance of spaying and neutering puppies, puppy diseases, and so on. Other assignments in this class include doing research over the course of a few days and creating informational reports on that specific topic. The Small Animal Care class helps students learn more about responsibility, patience, the well-being of animals, as well as encouraging jobs within the animal care work field. Reporting from Blythewood High School, I'm Ella Jean Simon, signing off.
Gabby, what's your favorite candy?
Well, I don't like chocolate, so it'll probably have to be Starburst. What about you, Ella?
It's hard to choose, but Sour Patch Kids is definitely one of my favorites.
I wonder what our classmates like. Are they even doing anything for Halloween?
I don't know. Let's see.
What's the best Halloween candy?
In my opinion, the best Halloween candy is Swedish Fish or like those little Twizzler packs that you get.
Probably candy
corn. I like Swedish Fish.
I'm planning on getting a group of friends together and just kind of dressing up. I'm going to go hang out with my little kids team and I'm going to dress up, just all for fun.
I'll probably just go trick-or-treating with my siblings.
Probably with my friends.
Popular Halloween costume? I've heard a lot of Barbie Ken, definitely. And Wally and Evie, I've seen a lot of those.
Probably like Grim Reaper or something.
Barbie-themed costumes.
This week, we sent out a Halloween survey to ask how old was too old to trick-or-treat.
About 51% of students said you are never too old to go trick-or-treating.
About 10% of students said that 14 is when you stop, and 38% of students said that 18 is when you should stop trick-or-treating.
We also asked students what they were dressing up as for Halloween, and we got some interesting responses.
We sure did. Some said that they were going as cats, others said that they were dressing up as Bob Ross, and we also had a response from someone who planned to go as a bag of Cheetos.
Those sound like some creative costumes. Anyway, that's all for today.
Thank you for watching, and we'll see you soon.
Have a spooky Halloween!